can't see a thing. Maybe I should have thought this through. The light. Another TV. Dark. How am I supposed to drag this thing out of here? Fine, Jesse. You're okay. Just don't drop.
Thank you. Thank you.
the way out. Up there.
Life's been a strange one, certainly stranger than I'd like, but this place, it's something else. The floors crawl, the walls slither, it's a shifting pit. On the street, it's just another drab building standing there for anyone to see, but no one does. How did we miss it? Northmore. Acting director Northmore now is on a train from Washington. He'll expect answers, which is why I'm making these tapes. They're evidence that I'm at least trying to understand. Father searched his entire life for something like this, and we find it 1 week after he's buried. He always hated irony. Of course, Father, the great director Ash, would have been the first man in. And look at me. His bookworm son, the supposed head of research who can't stop his legs from shaking long enough to step over the threshold.
fingernail. Pile of smoking rubble.
Marshall blew up the nail? What the hell was she thinking?
Since entry day, the name of our historic arrival to the oldest house. Morale is long dead, and its corpse is starting to smell. My research staff complain of a presence watching them. Many have suffered nervous fits. Some were evacuated. In cheerier news, I've made some new friends. I met them while exploring the deeper caves. They're hard to describe, but imagine avant-garde sculptures of humans. I call them the Id. They aren't hostile. In fact, they're polite and quiet, which is more than I can say for my colleagues. Most Id are shy, but a few are quite curious. While I sat taking notes, one came to look at my sketches. I offered him my pencil, but that spooked it. What are the Id? Residents? Prisoners? They remind me of the golems from Kabbalistic texts, or a type of homunculi. I know I shouldn't, but I gave them names. There's Hercules, Adam, Lilith, Copernicus. Mabel is the bravest. They're a funny bunch.